Please welcome from the Netherlands, Wim Hof.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Welcome.
Thank you.
So, in snowy Stockholm this morning, there was only one man in shorts.
I don't know who.
Tell me, this is a normal February, March outfit for you.
December, January, February, the whole winter.
The whole winter.
Yes.
Do you ignore the pain or do you embrace the pain? Because to freeze is pain, after all.
Yes, you could say that, but I love it. It's not that I love pain, but I don't feel that pain. I've learned to react the way we actually are built to resist cold. We always wear clothes. And then the body doesn't get stimulated. And if you wear a little bit less, then the vascular system is being exercised.
So according to you, we can stimulate this system by freezing?
Freezing and breathing. Breathing, the first thing you do when you go into the cold is, that is life force. And what we have done in our Western society, the civilization, is shallow breathing. We don't give the life force to our legs, arms, our body, and it becomes in a bad condition.
So how do you breathe? But
nice. And we lost that way of breathing. And thus the life force doesn't get everywhere.
What is it that does that? Because I feel like I have a lot of that breathing that's just like a little bit up here. And I've tried your breathing exercise and I thought it was so hard just to, like, I got dizzy, I got emotional and all of those things.
Exactly. That's what it is. You get into your emotion.
Yeah.
And you learn to be in areas where you have no control normally is why you become dizzy. If you would do it with me now, 20 breaths, you would be able to hold your breath without air in your lungs for 1 minute.
You want to try?
Yeah, we can do it.
Now you take them fully in from the belly into the chest, into your head, like this. And let it go. And fully in. Let it go. Fully in. Let it go. Don't mind about nothing, just the breath. Fully in. Let it go. Three. Fully in. Let it go. Two. Fully in. Let it go. Okay, now comes the last one. Fully in. And now you let it go and stop. No breathing. Shut your mouth, yes, your lips. Nice, okay.
Should I worry now? Because
no, she is still there and it's all okay. And in a couple of seconds, she will die in 5 minutes, but not now. No, I'm making a joke. Fully in. Take a fully in, hold. And squeeze a little bit to your head because it's a nice feeling. And that is bringing blood flow through the spine into the head. Very good before shows. You become really tranquil. Done. Well done.
Wow. Okay.
That was nice.
Yeah.
What did you feel now, honest?
No, I felt like I was like, dude.
In the beginning?
Yeah. No, dizzy, sleepy, very, like, relaxed, but almost like you're high on something, like you can't, so you're not, I didn't
That's what
feel,
we always now, say, get high on your own supply.
Yeah. Okay.
This is very difficult to do if you're out in the cold, because, I mean, just doing this, it's like your nose,
yeah, it closes
because
already, yeah.
It freezes to one, and breathing in is the hardest thing to do when it's minus 30 degrees or something.
30 breath, 40 breath, whatever it takes. And
listen,
it's okay.
You've done so many wild challenges. When did you push it too far?
Oh, a couple of times. couple of times. I'm always exploring for more. And
what happened when you pushed it too far?
I lose the control under the ice.
You swam.
Yeah, like a big like ice like this in Finland.
And you couldn't find the opening.
I couldn't find because my cornea froze. I couldn't see anymore. Where's the hole?
My God! Ugh.
And then you swim like 60 meters.
How long could you hold your breath then? Oh my God.
Under the ice, I don't talk. So, you know?
But how did you find the opening?
I didn't find the opening. I actually did twice the racket distance. And then a diver grabbed me by the ankle and brought me back to the 50-meter hole. And then when I came up there, out of there, I did... And then the other day, because this was the rehearsal, so there was no safety diver underneath because it was just a rehearsal. But for me, it was serious because the other day I had to do the world record. And there I conquered my concept of the fear of death. And that was a great lesson.
But you've also conquered... great sorrow, great tragedy in your life.
Oh, yes. I lost my wife in 95, the mother of my four children, and she jumped from 8 stories down. Oh. So this is the love of my life. And all psychiatry could not do anything. They gave her shots, they gave her pills and therapies, and it did not work. Went only down, 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 down. So there I stayed behind with my four kids. Very little money, and my kids made me survive. The cold water healed me. Because when you go into the cold water, your mind becomes still. You are just surviving. You are just there. You are not thinking about anything, so you're not thinking about a sorrow as well. For a moment, it is gone. And that brought relief to me. And from there, little by little, every day going into the cold water, it healed me emotionally. Now I work with my four kids. We got a flourishing business all over the world, bringing this message of happiness, strength, and health to the whole world. Yes.
Wim Hof, thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Wonderful letter.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed the clip. For more interesting conversations, please hit subscribe.